नमस्ते ऑल एंड वेलकम टू आर अपोलो लाइव सेशन. सो वी हैव अ स्पेशल टॉपिक फॉर टुडेज डिस्कशन, दैट इज़ व्हाट कैन यू एक्सपेक्ट फ्रॉम प्रिवेंटिव हेल्थ चेकअप. इन मॉडर्न लाइफस्टाइल देर आर सो मेनी चांसेस टू डेवलप वेरियस डिजीज लाइक ओबेसिटी, डायबिटीज एंड मोर, बट वॉट इफ वी कैन डिटेक्ट इन अ वेरी अर्ली स्टेज. कैन वी गेट आर सेल्फ क्योर्ड विद सम डिजीज इन अर्ली स्टेज बाय गेटिंग चेक्ड रेगुलरली. देर आर मेनी थिंग्स टू नो अबाउट आर लाइफस्टाइल एंड हेल्थ. To answer these all questions, we have Dr. Shashikant Nigam with us. Namaste, sir.
Namaste.
Dr. Shashikant Nigam, sir, is a consultant internal medicine at Apollo Hospital, Ahmedabad. Sir is MBBS and MD medicine. He has cleared for UPSC examination with merit for Indian Railway and has 37 years of experience in treating secondary level care for all the medical illness, including emergency, by Railway Chapter of Association of Physician of India. So, sir, there are many questions, and if you have any question, please drop it in a comment box and we'll start this discussion now. So, sir, first of all, we want to know that what is preventive health checkup?
Basically speaking, whenever we buy some important or costly gadget like car, fridge, washing machine, we take a license with them, maintenance license and regular checkup by the company. Whereas in case of our own body, we just never think that this is also equally important. Whatever happens, whenever we go to the doctor, we go only when there is some illness. But our body is much, much more important than the physical gadgets that are available in our home and society. So basically, the preventive health checkup is done to assess the status of our body, to know if there are any kind of problems or any kind of illnesses in our body, or there are any chances of development of any disorders in future, so that they can be addressed, taken care, and proper prevention and care can be taken, so that we don't have to suffer a sudden emergency in due course of time.
Sir, we would like to know about what are the NCDs.
Very good question. See, basically, more commonly, there are four or five types of disorders. One is the congenital diseases. Second is a communicable disorders like malaria, dengue, typhoid. Then there are disorders of degeneration that occurs in the old age. Then there are malignant diseases like cancers. Then there is a totally another group, which is non-communicable diseases like diabetes, blood pressure, hypertension. Now, these disorders are called non-communicable because they are not communicated from one to another person. Say for example, malaria, there could be epidemic. Say for example, right now COVID, it is communicated from one to another person. So that's a communicable disorder. Whereas in these non-communicable disorders, there is no chance of any kind of transmission from one person to another person. So these are called as non-communicable disorders.
Yeah. So sir, we'd like to know what are the basic tests that need to be done regularly?
See, health checkup has a very big gamut of disorders, but then everything is not fit for everyone. So we have to go step by step. There are certain basic health checkups where you have to do complete blood check, renal profile, liver profile, lipid profile, X-ray, ECGs, and the examination by physician and surgeons, and in case of females by gynecologist. So these are the basic tests which becomes a part of the basic health checkup.
Sir, is there any other disease which can be prevented by preventive health checkup?
There are so many disorders which are not exactly known as the diseases, which are not known to the public. Say for example, hypercholesterolemia and hyperuricemia, gout. They are generally not known to the general public as disease per se. And when these checkups are done, when there are the advanced checkups, where the additional things are being done for heart, advanced basic like TMT, 2D echo, and in case of very important case where there are very chances of high, even the advanced cardiac checkup like CT angio is also the part of the health checkup. So that is also done. In addition, for women, the additional checkup of pap smear, gynecological examination, breast examination, thyroid examination also done for those people. In elderly, since as they, but if it is not controlled, it can lead to a problem of the heart or brain or peripheral vascular disorders. Similarly, the kidney disorders. It is not a known phenomenon that kidney. Once the renal failure sets in, only then the people realize, okay, kidney is also there. Because in general talk non-NCDs, because basically people talk of only blood pressure, diabetes and hypertension. And all these disorders are basically lifestyle related. Since there is a lot of stress in our society nowadays because of the competitive lifestyle, fast lifestyle, and regularly people are not taking care of their health. The sleeping time has gone down. People are working more than 12 hours a day. Saturday, Sundays also are not very much relaxing. And because of the present status of COVID, people are not even socializing. People are not moving out. So all these things are basically adding to the stressful life situation as of now.
Sir, we would like to know that how preventive health checkup is important to any human life.
As I said earlier, that we buy a gadget and we take a sort of an annual maintenance contract. But in our body, since we grow up in our from our childhood, as the age advances, the growth occurs at a regular pace. In addition, there are chances of getting the illnesses. So when you are taking care of your body on a regular basis, the prevention can be done by knowing the things before it causes any kind of illness in the body. Say for example, blood pressure, if it is remained uncontrolled, unnoticed, it can cause a problem of the heart, brain, kidney and eyes. Similarly, the diabetes, if it is detected early, well before the actual symptoms occur, it can help to prevent the progress of complication of diabetes if proper care is taken on a due course of time. Similarly, the cholesterol, as I told you, if cholesterol is an unknown phenomenon, no one knows, but it can create trouble. Then there is another disorder which is called as metabolic syndrome, which is a combination of blood pressure, pre-diabetes, deranged lipids and abdominal obesity. So all these things are precursors of many diseases and many complications. Because we see that suddenly one person gets a heart attack, and then it comes to our knowledge that he is suffering from diabetes also. So all these things are very important, and the important requirement of this check is to know well before the things create a trouble for the person.
Sir, in the case if I am visiting a hospital for preventive health checkup and I am getting detected for any things like if I am having cholesterol or if I am having obesity, so what kind of treatment you line up for me?
So we assess the entire personal history, dietary history, then the family history, if anyone is having some kind of trouble in your family, and depending upon the age profile and weight profile, the dietary advice is being given to reduce the weight by proper instruction through dietitian. If required, we monitor it on a regular basis. If you are a young person, we try to avoid for some time. But if there is a familial hypercholesterolemia, then we do not wait for starting the medicines. Because cholesterol per se, being familial cholesterolemia, can create more trouble even at a younger age. So if you have this thing, hypercholesterolemia, you have to do for your yoga, exercise, weight reduction, diet control, and importantly, mental relaxation is one of the most important feature of control of all these non-communicable disorders, in particular unknown disorder like hypercholesterolemia. Yeah.
So we have received a query for from a viewer that, hi sir, if a person is recovered from COVID and due to COVID, newly hypertension and mellitus diabetes has been developed, which tests are important for them and recovered patient for next year?
For diabetes, the fasting blood sugar, postprandial blood sugar, HbA1c is the important test for control of diabetes. For blood pressure, we have to assess the blood urea, creatinine and urine, and abdominal sonography to know what is the status of their kidney. Does this BP was persisting, or if there is no history, then we have to check what is the level of hypertension. And when we see the weight, height, weight, cholesterol levels, and depending on those things, the dietary advice is the first advice, then the physical activity is another advice, salt restriction in case of hypertension, and for diabetes, the dietary advice of control of carbohydrates, no additional sugars, avoidance of sweet fruit like mango, chiku, grapes, and banana. So these advices are very important, and then on continuously monitoring them, the if required medicines have to be started depending upon the profile level of the HbA1c in case of diabetes.
So then there is another one that sir, if a person has coughing problem from many years, then what test needs to be done to know the root of the problem? He is tested negative for TB.
Okay. So once you say you have a chronic cough, you have tested negative for tuberculosis. So fundamentally speaking, there is a status of a chronic cough. Now chronic cough can be because of the pollution. And in that case, we have to do the XHS, as you were saying, ruled out for tuberculosis. We have to do the pulmonary function test. If it shows any kind of restrictive or obstructive lung disorder, we have to do the medicines according to that thing. If those things are normal, and if there are signs of breathlessness, increasing breathlessness, then we have to go for CT chest to rule out interstitial lung diseases. If all these things are normal, sometimes what happens, the reflux esophagitis causes a severe irritation in throat, and person have no lung problem, still that reflux esophagitis causes a throat irritation, and chronic cough can be a cause of it. In that case, endoscopy is required to be done to confirm or rule out the cause of cough.
Yeah. Sir, what is the youngest possible age to get the health check done?
Ideally speaking, whenever a young person who has a family history should get his first BP checkup by the age of 18 years. But if those things are not there, then the person whenever he gets a new job, I say around the age of 25 to 30 years, the medical checkup should be done. Then in a preventive part of checkup, the youngest age of the patient where we need to do a one particular test, that's a case of a newborn baby born to a mother who has got hypothyroidism. So in this setting, we have to rule out the baby getting in a hypothyroid state, because hypothyroid state in a baby, if not tackled at a proper time, may lead to cretinism. And the biggest disadvantage of cretinism is, apart from the short height, there is a mental capabilities are little down. So the level of intelligence IQ goes down. So in such cases, the control of hypothyroidism in baby is very, very important. And depending upon the reports, proper therapy for the baby should be started.
So sir, as we have discussed about NCDs, and it is very common nowadays. So is there any specific or special package for that?
Yes, there is a special package that we are coming, which is called as ProHealth. In this ProHealth, one was the executive checkup or health check. In ProHealth checkup, we take a person's participation, whether he is sick or not sick, or if he has illness for a long time. Basically, this is a program where it's a very well charted program, where there is a part of the patient himself, he gives his data. Based on his data, his age, sex, family history, personal history, and the history of any illnesses past, the prediction has been made. And then based on that, the health mentor assessment is there, which continues for the period of 3 years. And basic purpose is, we have to do what you call, we have to predict, we have to prevent and overcome whatever illnesses is already having. This program runs for 3 years. It's a facility for all specialists. Whenever required, there is a health assessment person in between. Person can contact us, and the biggest advantage that a person does not need to come to the hospital on each and every occasion. So basically, this is a digital health basis, artificial data, where there are set parameters known in the population, and then the based on the data of the patient, it is predicted that what complications he can face in near course of time, and based on those assessment, patient is advised, he becomes a part of his own therapy, he follows with us, he can follow from his home, he does not need to come to our hospital every time, and he can have requirement, whatever is there, they are also fulfilled. In case if somebody is not possible to collect medicines, even medicines are delivered at their doorstep. So this is basically for corporates and individuals, where the additional beyond the health check, it's a pro health, we are predicting, preventing and overcoming with the help of the patient himself, because he becomes a party. And it's a digital health, it's on a app based platform which is going to be launched very soon, where person can join the program, and its program is for 3 years, where all these things are taken care, even include if there is a requirement of any physiotherapy. Say for example, the senior citizen is there, the even physiotherapy can be imparted at their places.
Sir, how it is different from a basic health check process?
Now in the basic health check, we are generally taking, person is coming, he thinks that he is absolutely normal, and then we detect. In pro health, we are detecting even a person who already has got some illnesses, maybe he is taking, not taking treatment with us, but if he has any kind of illnesses, so based on those illnesses and their parameters, he himself becomes a part of us, he gives his data, if data is fed and it is through artificial intelligence, we predict the, what are his chances of getting illnesses, what is the percentage, and what intervention should be done depending upon the risk involvement. So this, the difference is the person becomes a part of the program even when he has. The important part is that he becomes a part of it, because there is a health mentor with whom he can communicate any point of time, and if required, person can take help of any specialist of any Apollo Hospital in India. So basic advantage that they get a bigger platform for their support.
Sir, health check is like very important nowadays. So how it helps to improve a lifestyle?
Of course, it is most important thing to improve the lifestyle. We talk of lifestyle disorders like stress and all those things, but most important things are being missed, that the lack of sleep, stress management. People are being advised to have a yoga, meditation, which is also a part of this pro health. Negative stress that leads to all such kind of things like blood pressure, diabetes, because we have a feeling something can go wrong. We should have feeling, but absolute thinking on negative lines is absolutely wrong. What is required, most important thing, is have a positive thinking, relax yourself, try and relax yourself, avoid any kind of hindrances whatever possible, have good sleep, a good diet. Most important thing, one has to be very, very cautious what type of diets take. For example, all kind of toxic substances like tobacco and cigarette, they should all be avoided at any cost. They do not help anyone in any way.
Yeah. Sir, as we have discussed about health checkup and how to prevent things in early stage, so can you share any incidents or any example that if we have found any case that has been detected in early stage and it has not become a big disease?
It's a recent case, a young girl of around 30 years of age, just because the other members in family at the time of health check is most important, and following it up with the patient is also very important. Hypercholesterolemia per se is not a disease, but since there is a family history, there is a hypercholesterol, and the control of diet, physical activity, exercises, yoga and meditation has helped her to reduce her cholesterol in a span of 6 months to normal levels.
Sir, in this COVID pandemic, patients do not feel to visit hospitals. They want to stay home, and they should stay home. So do we have any option that if it can be done at home, or is it safe to visit hospital?
Now, second question first. Apollo Hospital is very safe to visit at any point of time, even in the era of COVID pandemic, because the proper precautions are being taken. The COVID areas are totally separate, non-COVID areas are totally separate. Every staff is being trained how to check the disinfection, and this disinfection is available all throughout the hospital. So absolutely there is no problem in visiting Apollo Hospital. As far as your first part is concerned, if person does not feel like to come to hospital, there is a app-based program which is called Ask Apollo. Person can register on it and look for the doctors to whomsoever he or she wants to consult and book the appointment with them. And it's a teleconsultation where the face-to-face through video conferencing is done with the patient, and based on the report, person can load his reports on the file, and these are seen by the doctor on the other side, and discussion face to face, proper advice and proper treatment are being imparted, and this can be done on a regular basis, every monthly basis.
So sir, at last we want to get a message from you for all the viewers to have a healthy lifestyle and a good health.
Dear friends, today's most important message is that stress is causing all kinds of troubles. Stress impacts your diet, because if you are in stress, either you take less food or more food. You avoid exercising. So avoid stress, take good diet, good exercise, and take care of your health in a very nice way. And my last message is, stay safe, stay healthy. Three important things: use always mask, social distancing, and frequent hand wash. Thank you very much.
So here we would like to thank Dr. Shashikant Nigam sir for staying with us and who has given his precious time to us. Also, don't wait for any symptoms to get developed, just get yourself checked time to time. And Apollo Hospital is very safe, as sir said. To know about our packages and detail, and to book an appointment, just call 769-88-15028, and also you can visit our website Ask Apollo. Thank you so much.